Hello everyone. In this video, we will be discussing a bevel gear numerical. So already in the previous videos, we have discussed many varieties of bevel gears, that is basically designing. But apart from the designing, even there are chances they may ask some other problems also in bevel gear. So in this video, we will be discussing such kind of problem. So let us go through the question. What is given? A pair of identical straight tooth meter gears listed in a catalog has a diametrical pitch of 5 at the larger end and 25 teeth, 1.1 inches of face width and a 20 degree normal pressure angle. The gears are grade 1 steel, through hardened with a core and a case hardness of 180 Brinell. The gears are uncrowned and intended for general industry use. They have a quality number of 7. It is likely that application intended will require outboard mounting of the gears. Use a safety factor of 1 into 10 power 7 cyclic life and 0.99 reliability. For the speed of 600 revolution per minute, find the power rating of the gears based on AGMA strength. And for the same condition as in part A, find the power rating of the gear set based on AGMA VS strength. And third one is for a reliability of 0.995, a gear life of 10 power 9 revolutions and a safety factor of 1.5. So find the power rating for this gear set using AGMA strength. So if you see this particular problem, even the wordings and even the way the output was asked, it is entirely different from the problems what we discussed previously. And moreover, this particular problem was not asked in the university examination, but this question was available in the VTU prescribed textbook, that is a foreign author textbook, which was authored by Maxwell. So we will see how to solve this particular problem. So along with this particular problem, even sketches also given. In case the sketches not given, means no issues, from the design data handbook chapter 15 we can take it down, from the sketches 15.14 and 15.15, where the pitch diameter, which is equal to np by p, that is the value I'm getting, everything here I'll be getting calculating in terms of inches. If you are not okay with the inches, you can even convert that into mm. For you people should be aware, like whether it is given in inches, centimeter or mm, whatever thing, you people should be able to solve it. So for that purpose only, I am solving this problem in inches only. And moving to the VT, so the formula is pi dp np by 12. So here I know the dp value and n value. So while substituting, I am getting VT value 785.4. Feet per minute I am getting. Again, you can able to see here, inches is converted into feet. Now the overload factor, that is uniform loading, from the table 15.2, where the service factor is a 1, and which is already given in the question also. So we need not to take it. In case if it is not given, means we need to take the value from the table 15.2, and the service factor, safety factor, which is given as 1 for both SF and SH in the question itself. And moving to the dynamic factor, from the equation 15.6, the formula would be, for A and B, already I have calculated the A value 65.06 and B value is 0.731. While substituting A and B value, I am getting the velocity factor KV as 1.299. And moving to the next one, based on this KV value, I will be finding out, okay, whether the module I will be finding out based on the range I will be finding out. So here you can able to see, like I am getting keep on increasing, like 1.25, like that I am keep on increasing, and finally I am getting the K value as 1, because this is the required range we are looking for, which is closer to 1. So it is 0.9996, that is the value. And so the CL value is 3.4822. 10 power 7 of KL value, or what we have what we have got, that is I value. So it is 1.32, and since HPP by HBG is equal to 1, from the sketch in the data handbook which is available, I'll be writing CH value is 1, again from the equation KX is 1 and KT is equal to 1 from the same sketch. If you go through the design data handbook, the soft copy, we can able to find it out. So the KR value is 0.70 minus 0.15 log of 1 minus 0.99. So KR value is 1. And the CR value, again from the formula root of KR, that is root 1, which is equal to 1. And next is the bending. So the formula is S of 80, that is equal to 44 into 180 plus 2100. So which is in terms of PSI I am getting, that is, so answer is 10020. PSI I'm getting. And moving to the ST, where it is also nothing but the stress. So the formula is W by F into PD into KO into KV into KS KM divided by KX into J. So WT is the unknown here, and I know the stress value. So F is 1.10, PD is 5, KO is 1, and KV is 1.299, KS is 0.529, KM is 1.254. KX is 1 and J is 0.216. You can able to see everything I'm substituting in terms of normal PSI and inches. So the stress value I'm getting in terms of W. So 18.13 WT I'm getting. That is the tangential force of the wheel. Next is SWT. The formula is SAT into KL divided by SF into KT into KR. These are all the new formulas which is which we have not discussed in the previous problems. In case if it is asked, means you should be knowing how to find out. So here also everything is known. ST value we know, KL value we know, SF, KT, KR, everything is one. So SWT also I am getting the same value as SAT, that is 10020. Then equating SC and SWT, where I can able to find out the W value. So I am getting it as 552.6 LBF I am getting. And next is H. So that is value is WT into VT divided by 33,000. So while substituting WT and VT, I am getting H as 13.2 HP. And moving to the next one, VR, the formula is SCAC, that is 341 into 180 plus 23 into 620. So it is 85,000 PSI. So the allowable stress value is equal to 112 to 112200 PSI. This is the allowable compressive stress I am getting. Then now CP value, that is 2290 square root of PSI, where from definition we can write it down. So CS value I am getting as 0.575. So sigma C value I am getting as 5242 root of WT. So equating sigma C and sigma C allowable, I will be getting the value as 5242 root of WT, which is equal to 112200. So from this WT value, I'm getting 458.1. So previously also, what is the WT value we got? I got 552.6 I got here. But here, based on this condition, that is the wear condition, I'm getting the WT value as 458.1. And H value is 458.1 into 785.4 divided by 33,000. So H value I'm getting as 10.9 H power. Here the power value you can able to horsepower I'm writing, not in terms of kilowatts. Since all the values WT, LBF, PSI, all those things I'm substituting. So H value I'll be getting in terms of horsepower. So the rated power for the gear set, this H is equal to minimum of 12.9 to 10.9. So I'll be going with 10.9 HP. And life goal, that is 10 power 9 cycle from the equation 15.15. So the KL value I'm getting as 1.68 into 10 power 9 of the value whatever I got in the previous end, like 0.0323. So KL value I'm getting as 0.861618. So previously we assumed KL as 1, but in case of the wear and life cycle, the values are different. And similarly, KR value by using the formula in this one, like root of KR. So that is CR value. So KR value I'm getting as 1.075, and CR is nothing but root of KR, that is 1.037. And finally, CL also will be finding out with the known values. So the CL value I'm getting as 1. And last step is nothing but the bending. So bending, I'll be finding out SCAT and ST. So ST I'm getting as 18.13, and SWT I'm getting a 5355. And by equating ST and SWT, since both I'll be getting ST, I'm getting W. So from this, I'll be finding out the unknown W value is 295.4. And from this, the power value, as usual, I'm substituting. So I'm getting H7 HP. So the same thing will be continued for the other problems also, in case if it is asked. So mostly these kind of problems will not be asked in units and examination. Just for the general knowledge purpose, this is mentioned here. Okay, thank you.